Everybody, this video is to show you some of the new requirements slash standardizations that we want to have for our courses in Academy Central for next year. Now that we have a year under our belt, we've discovered a few things that we could do to make life a little simpler for students and also parents, as they're going to have their own account next year for Academy Central. So I'm going to first show you what your course should look like roughly, and then in a follow-up video I'll show you how to make that happen. So just a few changes here, and the first of which is that we want to have a what we call splash screen or splash page that students and parents see right away when they click on your course. So so for example, if I had first logged in as a student and I'm in this view, when I go up and click on the U.S. Military History course, it will automatically go to this page. We want to make sure that happens. And there are basically three parts to this page. There's the course description slash pertinent information section, and a picture, which is optional. You don't have to do that. I only put that there because I've seen some teachers really get into putting up pictures on Academy Central. And then a link entitled Enter Course. So really the only optional thing here is the picture. The other two things we want to have, we want parents to kind of show up to a course and get a quick rundown of what the course is about. This is simply a copy and paste of what's in your syllabus probably in terms of the course description. We don't want tons of information here because what we have found is that if there's too much information here, or if there isn't any information here, then parents and students get confused. They struggle to find resources that they need. So just something really brief and informative. So I have my course description here and then my year-long essential questions. So the students are reminded what we are covering, big picture, as well as the parents. Then we have the Enter Course button, or link, I should say, and when you click on that, that is going to send you to your course modules page. And we want everybody to use course modules to organize the contents of their course. And again, I'll show you in the follow-up video on how to do that. But you can see I have broken it down into essential resources, unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, etc. I don't really care how you set up your modules. A lot of courses, it's useful to set up in terms of units. Other courses are more topical, and so you might have different topics for your modules. But again, these modules are acting like buckets or folders that contain all the pertinent information for a particular time of your studies with the students. So you can see within the modules, I have my podcasts, slides, quizzes, assignments, etc. So that is the second requirement, that you use course modules. Finally, we want to make sure on the left-hand side here that you only have tabs available to students that they need. So if there are a bunch of tabs that you don't use, like conferences, discussions, outcomes, etc., we want to hide those from the student view, because again, if all these different classes have all these different tabs, then it can get a little confusing for the student. So if you click on the settings tab down here, there is a way to see what the student sees. They've just added this feature a few weeks ago. In the upper right hand corner, we have what's called the student view. I click on that, and now this is what the student sees when they enter my course. So you can see on the left hand side, only three tabs are available to them because that's what I made available to them. And again, I will show you how to do that in the follow-up video. And then, you know, you can arrange these however you would like, probably, and you know, you want to arrange them in what you feel is most important for your class. So, for example, if you're having discussions every day, you know, for homework or whatever, you might take the discussions tab, make it visible, and then put it as the second tab. You probably will want to make the modules tab your second tab, just because that obviously contains all of your course content. And then after that, I choose to have grades because I'm sure students will be looking for that as well. But you put announcements up there, whatever is pertinent for you. So if you're using all of it, leave it all there, but I doubt that we are. So we'll pull out what students don't need to see. So those are the minimum requirements in terms of how your course is set up. Of course, you're going to be doing grades on here as well, which is a third video that I'll be doing here shortly. So if you have any questions, let me know. And that's about it.